zurück beim Sitzblitz mit dem Rockbock und Bohemian Killing. Tja, wir sind stehen geblieben, als wir bei dem Nachbarn waren und ich den Brief gelesen habe. So. Sieht alles sehr schön aus. Gucken wir mal nach, da ist er ja. Zack.
For a good 10 minutes I talked to Monsieur Brissot. And again we had an argument about la Révolution. Monsieur Brissot felt regret that in modern France the high birth was no longer relevant. Also he boasted that he had hired a maid. I do not know where he found the money for her salary and did not see any effects of her work. His apartment was a mess, as usual. Wasn't that an odd thing for you? Yes, Monsieur le Président. If someone hires a servant, one can expect order. And in this apartment, there was none.
Did your neighbor say anything else about the maid?
Yes, I was going to say it. It turned out that it was Marie Capet, my old classmate. We grew up in the same city, and I had not known that she had moved to Paris.
So you admit that you knew the victim?
Oui, I knew who she was. I opened the door to the living room.
Da ist ja jemand drin. Oh, ich bin unsichtbar. Ich bin ein Vampir.
I was curious to see behind the door, but did not want to offend my host by nosing around. I was curious to see behind the door, but did not want to.
Okay, da geht's wohl nicht lang. Dann gehen wir mal nach oben.
Then I opened the door and left the apartment.
Die Musik ist sehr schön.
I decided to use the stairs instead of the elevator. I knocked, but no one answered. I checked the light switch to see. I opened the door and entered my apartment.
Ah, da wohnt er.
I glanced on the frames hanging on the wall. Their simplicity calmed me down and allowed me to focus. For a moment, I admired the new sculptures that I had recently ordered. I stared out the window. At the quiet street of Montmartre. Then I opened the elevator grate. I used my freight elevator to go to the basement.
Wieder einen eigenen Fahrstuhl? Krasser Scheiß. Oh, jeder hätte gerne seinen eigenen Fahrstuhl, ne? In seinem Haus, in seiner Wohnung. Aber hier ist ja nichts.
For a moment, oh. I watched the fireworks over the rooftops of Paris.
Sieht toll aus. Sehr schön.
I examined the condition of the pipe which delivered packages from a local warehouse to my vending machine. Then I opened the grate of my private elevator. I took the freight elevator to my apartment. Usually I use it to take up boxes with parts from the basement. I opened the elevator grate.
Das ist mein Bad nehmen.
Washing away any traces of blood. I opened the inner door. I examined the new sculptures in my apartment. They beautifully... Then I opened the door.
Erstmal was futtern, ne?
I ate the leftovers from my lunch and okay. drank some wine.
Der Wein hat gleich reingehauen. Ich sehe alles doppelt. Oder verschwommen, besser gesagt.
I ate the leftovers from my lunch and drank some wine. I ate the leftovers from my lunch and drank some wine.
Ich baller mich jetzt richtig zu. Na, geht nochmal? Nee. Oh, der Rausch ist schon vorbei. Na gut, war ein schneller Rausch. Gehen wir mal nach oben. Schicke Pflanze.
I use the stairs.
Ich dachte gerade, der hat eine Guillotine hier zu stehen.
Prototype and considered what else should be done.
Erstmal ackern.
I started to work on my new cleaning machine. After 30 minutes, I decided to take a break.
Wer klopft denn da? Komm her, komm her.
I use the stairs.
Ja, ich bin ja schon da.
I heard someone knocking at the
door. Oh, Taschen.
I opened it and there she was. I invited Marie Capet inside. She said she remembered me from school and was curious how things turned out for me. She had been recently hired as a maid by my neighbor, Monsieur Brissot. I showed her my apartment, my designs and inventions. She was delighted. So I thought maybe she would be interested in my interrogation machine. I took her to my private workshop.
Okay. Turn the machine. Turn on.
I turned down my prototype machine to interrogate prisoners. Then, I felt a blow to my head, and I collapsed on the floor.
Oh.
I woke up some time later. My head ached, and I was all covered in blood. Marie Capet was nowhere to be found. I read for a while about the history of torture.
Are you interested in this subject?
It is not about hurting someone, but to use pain as one of the methods to convince someone to testify.
Do you think it is acceptable to inflict pain during the interrogation?
In extreme cases, yes. But my advice is not inflicting it. And the prosecutor naming my device the torture machine only shows his deep ignorance on that subject.
Order, please. And I admonish the accused to make no offense to any of the participants of this trial. Please, return to your testimony.
I turned off my prototype machine. I saw a metal rod on the ground. I saw that the safe was open. And Capet had stolen the designs of my most important invention.
Why do you think Madame Capet did it?
I don't know, Monsieur le Président, but I was going to find out.
No. Finden wir es heraus. Sollte vielleicht nochmal duschen, ne? Go to sleep? Nee. Sollte, glaube ich, nochmal ein Bad nehmen, ne?
Then I opened the door. I used the stairs. I took a bath, washing away any traces of blood. Then I used the stairs. minutes talking on the phone.
Who did you call?
It has nothing to do with the case, Monsieur le Président.
Well, please continue.
Ich wollte die Bullen rufen. Hä? Was ist das denn?
I was tired after the banquet, so I immediately went to sleep.
Ich wollte eigentlich die Polizei rufen.
I was even too tired to undress.
Is it all you want to testify, Monsieur Eaton?
Oui, Monsieur le Président.
And so I close the hearing. It is time to present your positions.
Monsieur le Président, the accused tried to trick himself off the responsibility. He used cunning rhetoric, trying to hide more and more of his new lies. However, in view of the evidence presented by the prosecutor, I have no doubt that Alfred Eaton, defendant who appeared today before the court, murdered Marie Capet in cold blood. Please, let the High Court not be deceived by his tearful stories about a poor gypsy from the country who gained his success with hard work and which Marie Capet so cleverly tried to destroy. It was the accused who destroyed the life of a poor girl and her family with full premeditation. And what did that poor girl do to deserve such cruel fate? She was searching for a better life and was employed as a maid in the same building in which a dangerous psychopath lived. According to the prosecution, the accused is guilty, Monsieur le Président. Therefore, I apply for recognition of Alfred Eaton, defendant who appeared today before the court, guilty of all charges against him, and for imposition of the death penalty by beheading on the guillotine.
At niemals.
Monsieur le Président, Monsieur Prosecutor used a lot of high-flown words. However, during the preparation of indictment, he made many mistakes. As to the hotel room, my client had never rented a room in the Caucasus Hotel. The guest book was falsified, and the clerk made a false statement. As to the alleged attempt to use the torture device on the victim, my client did not intend to use his interrogation device, which the prosecutor describes as a torture machine, neither on Marie Capet nor on anyone else. This is indicated by the letter sent by my client to the Ministère de la Justice with a proposal of a lawful use of the equipment to serve the law as well as society. It is important to emphasize the relationship of Marie Capet and my client. According to the testimony of the victim's parents, she felt a deep resentment and contempt, both for my customer and for his work and success. As to the meeting with Marie Capet in his apartment, indeed, Marie Capet came to visit my client at his apartment, and Alfred Eaton let her in, not expecting such a sudden attack. Hence the victim's fingerprints in the apartment of my client, and traces of Monsieur Eaton's blood, which were mentioned by the prosecutor. As for Alfred Eaton's weapon, please note, Monsieur le Président, that my client testified that he had not had the murder weapon on himself. The knife was in his secret workshop all that time. Everyone could have stolen it and then dropped it off. As for the murder, as my client testified, he did not kill Marie Capet. So, who did? As it clearly appears from the letter to Monsieur Brissot, the maid, Marie Capet, was sent shortly before the murder. I would like to add that the letter was sent from a non-existent organization, and remuneration for Marie Capet's work was not provided. So who and why had she been sent? As for the testimony of the neighbor who saw Alfred Eaton entering the building covered in blood, according to my client's testimony, that meeting had never taken place. So the witness made a false testimony. Taking into account the evidence from the neighbor's opinions, the witness might have had a motive, an aversion towards my client, and racial prejudice. Thank you, Monsieur le Président.
Tja. Der Knast. Na toll.
Father and I are quite sure that you did not do it. You couldn't have. We love you and we are waiting for you at home.
Ich bin völlig unschuldig.
Leave this cursed Paris and return to your home parts. Mama et Papa. P.S. Papa asks you not to mention the hotel guestbook. Apparently you know what that means. Your father and I are praying for you, and we believe that the court will be merciful. Maman et Papa. Postscriptum. Papa is sorry that it did not work as he had planned. I am in a deep regret that you had to stand before the court accused of such a terrible deed. I assure you that I deeply believe in your innocence and will do my best so that you can continue to work for the glory of Le Feu and toute la France. Cordialement, Hugo Argent. You deeply scum. You can be sure that you will take responsibility for what you have done to our daughter. You will be beheaded, and even neither your millions nor your connections will be able to help you. Is the stolen money not enough? Is your wrongdoing to all these poor people not enough? You had to tear everything away from us, including our only daughter. Death to the rich. Vive la nouvelle révolution. Monsieur Le Pen, the French Gypsy Association wishes to send you support and condolences for the persecution caused by your gypsy origin. We are aware that it was the main cause of your indictment. We offer you a safe haven if you decide to leave the prison in less official way. One of our persecuted members, who had also been imprisoned in the prison de la Santé, mentions the decayed walls in most of the cells. Maybe you could use this information. Signed, X.
Tja, X. Ist klar. Okay, die haben jedenfalls jemanden drin. Das bringt wohl nichts. Mal schlafen noch, ne?
Monsieur Eaton, please hurry. The court is ready to announce the verdict.
Oh. Okay, es geht weiter.
The verdict on behalf of the République Française. The court, as present, hereby finds that Alfred Eaton, accused of murdering Marie Capet, is guilty of the charges against him, and sentences the accused to the death penalty by beheading on the guillotine. The executions will be done in Prison de la Santé the next day.
Was? Niemals. Die wollen mich killen. Oh mein Gott, mit der Guillotine. Discovered game ending. Okay. Tot. Oh mein Gott. Ich will nicht. Ja. Tja, liebe Freunde, das war Bohemian Killing und ihr habt jetzt ein Ende von 9 gesehen. Und ich kann das nur empfehlen, ich finde das gar nicht so schlecht, aber man sollte schon sehr gut Englisch dafür können. Ich habe ehrlich gesagt nur die Hälfte verstanden, das hat jetzt natürlich ausgereicht, aber besser wäre es, wenn man natürlich mehr machen kann. Tja, ich denke, ich werde das jetzt noch ein bisschen weiterspielen und ihr solltet es euch vielleicht mal anschauen. Also, bis dann, euer Rockbock, ciao!